Welcome to the Ancestral Quest overview video. We'll start this video by giving you an overview of what Ancestral Quest can do for you, then give you a few examples of how to use Ancestral Quest. Ancestral Quest will help you to record your family history by helping you to enter names, dates, places, photos, documents, notes, and sources. Organize your family history by connecting all this data in meaningful ways and producing lists, charts, and research logs. Research your family history by helping you search major online family history websites such as Ancestry.com and FamilySearch.org. Share your family history by printing beautiful wall charts, publishing family books, and creating web pages. Ancestral Quest is certified with FamilySearch to let you link your data with the family tree of FamilySearch and upload your data to the family tree. If you have already used another program to begin recording your family tree data, we'll show you in a minute how you can easily import your work into Ancestral Quest. But first, let's assume you are new to genealogy and show you some of the basics. Just one more thing, there is a more detailed tutorial called the Quick Start Video Tutorial, which was produced using an older version of Ancestral Quest. The basics of the program haven't changed much, so you will probably want to watch all or parts of this tutorial. It is divided into 15 different lessons, running about 3 to 12 minutes per lesson. It teaches you not only how to work with the basics of Ancestral Quest, but also provides many suggestions on best practices for recording genealogical information. If you purchased Ancestral Quest on a CD, you will find this tutorial on the CD. Once you have installed either Ancestral Quest or Ancestral Quest Basics, you'll be able to start the program from the desktop. If you purchased Ancestral Quest, you will have a key. Simply click on Use Ancestral Quest to enter your key and start using the full version. You will never see this screen again. If you intend to use the free Ancestral Quest Basics version of the software, simply click on Use Ancestral Quest Basics. Each time you start Ancestral Quest Basics, it will present this screen. Simply click the same button each time to continue to use Ancestral Quest Basics for free. For now, let's use Ancestral Quest Basics. You may see this screen the very first time you run Ancestral Quest. You can either create a brand new family file if you're new to computerized genealogy, or open an existing Ancestral Quest, PATH, or GEDCOM file. You can import a GEDCOM file, or if a relative has already submitted your family information to FamilySearch, you can import family lines directly from FamilySearch. We won't cover these other advanced options in this tutorial, but we'll cover the first options in more detail later. For now, I want to show you what you can expect after you have entered a fair amount of data. So I'll open an existing file. For this tutorial, I have selected a public figure, President Eisenhower. Note that after you have entered a person, such as President Eisenhower, you can then enter spouses, children, and parents. As I navigate to the right to see additional generations, note that at any time I could add children to an existing family, or if I get to the end of a line, I would be able to add spouses, fathers, and mothers simply by clicking on Add Spouse, Add Child, Add Father, or Add Mother to continue growing the family tree. I could go back the way we came or simply click on the Home button to get back where we started. Let me take a look at the pedigree view, where you can more easily see large numbers of generations and navigate quickly between ancestral generations. Notice if I right-click on a person and make them the primary on this screen, they become the main person on the screen and their ancestry is shown. Again, we've gone out 4 generations. We can move back by clicking the left arrow till we get back home, or I could have used the Home button. Let's look on the information I've already entered for President Eisenhower. Make sure his name is highlighted. Click the Edit Individual button and we can see that I've entered his common information in the upper portion of the screen and additional event information down under Other Events. Notice by the asterisk on the source buttons or the X in the source column of other events, you can tell which events have been sourced. Let's click on the Note Sources button where you can view the notes or sources for either the individual or his relationships. We have entered some notes for President Eisenhower and we've entered various sources as you can see here. Let's go ahead and close this screen. and the edit screen. Now let me show you some reports. We'll click on the report and chart icon to bring up the reports and chart screen. The tabs at the top of the screen indicate various major report groups. Right now let's take a look at some pedigree charts. You'll be able to print either single charts, cascading sets, blank forms, or circular fan pedigree charts with lots of different options. Let's show you a single pedigree chart, which includes four generations and photos. You can zoom in to see more details, or zoom back out to see the full page. Like this pedigree chart, AncestralQuest Basics will produce many of the basic charts and reports available in AncestralQuest, but some reports and some advanced options require the full version of AncestralQuest. For example, printing a fan chart would require the full version. Also, printing notes and sources on a pedigree chart requires the full version, although you can print notes and sources on a family group sheet with the basics version. Remember that we have been working with the basics version until now. If I decide I want to use one of the more advanced options, such as sources, when I try to activate an advanced option, AncestralQuest Basics will remind me that this option requires the full version. At this point, I can continue using AncestralQuest Basics and choose not to use the advanced option, or I can purchase an activation key and then enter it. Let me go ahead and enter the key I just purchased. Then I will activate and continue. Now that I have successfully entered a valid key, all of the features of the program are available. So let me add sources, source images, and notes to this pedigree chart, and let's view it again. This time, notice that in addition to the names, dates, and places, we have some footnote numbers that indicate there are sources. If I go on to the next page, we can see that at the top we have some of the notes from the individuals on this chart, along with various sources. If we have attached original source documents to some of the sources, you'll see this, see attachment number 1 or 2 or whatever. If we go to subsequent pages, we can see the original documents. Let me go ahead and zoom out here. That accompanied these sources. Now that's a pretty cool chart, including all the original notes and sources to print up and share with family members. AncestralQuest has scores of different charts, wall charts, reports, books, and birthday and anniversary calendars that you can create once you have entered your information. Let's close the charts and reports screen. AncestralQuest has some powerful tools to help you locate individuals or groups within your file. If we go here to the list of names and open the advanced portion of the screen, we could simply scroll up or down or alphabetically search for somebody, but you can also locate groups of people based on how they relate to a selected person or based on which kinds of data are stored in their records. By combining these two types of requests, you have some very powerful tools to find and define groups. Also, if you go to the name list view, you can of course sort on name or on the record number, but AncestralQuest also lets you sort on any other field simply by clicking on the header of the column, and you can even subsort on up to 2 other fields. If you like the default colors of AncestralQuest, that's great, but if you would like to change them, you can go to Preferences and either use one of the predefined skins, such as the blue, or caramel, or any of a number of other predefined sets of colors, or you can define your own background color and other options. For now, we'll stick with the basic color scheme. By now you've noticed the language box here in the corner. If you're primarily an English user and don't intend to use other languages, simply drop this box, go to the bottom, and say hide the selection box, and you'll never see this box again. If you are speaking a different language, select your language from the list, and then you can use that language in the future. For now, we'll turn this off. Once you have entered at least a few records, AncestralQuest can help you search major online databases for additional information. For example, if you go to the pedigree view and then go to the view menu and turn on the ancestry.com links, you'll find that AncestralQuest will search ancestry.com in the background and show you how many trees are out on ancestry.com or other records that you could use. Simply by clicking these links, we'll take you out to ancestry.com In fact, let me show you here. Records on President Eisenhower's grandfather. Well, I could click on this link to 127 records. That will take me out to Ancestry.com, where I can scroll through the list of various records that they have available. To get access to most of these records, you would need a subscription to Ancestry.com. Notice that there are such things as federal censuses and other records. Let's go ahead and close this screen. Also, if you have the full version of Ancestral Quest, you can click on this icon here, which will search your favorite website. By default, we have set that to go to FamilySearch.org, but you can change that. So again, if I have highlighted a particular person in the database, whether on the pedigree chart or the family view, let's select Jacob F. Eisenhower and click on this icon to bring up a list of possible matches out on FamilySearch. Notice that we have access to such records as census records, some of which have pictures that you can then click on and view. By using the internet searching capabilities of Ancestral Quest, you can locate additional information on your family tree to continue to build it and have data available for the various charts and reports that you may want to produce. If you need to use some of the special features of Ancestral Quest, such as, let me go to preferences here, such as LDS data, you can turn that on in preferences. If you have access to Family Search, you can turn that on. For now, let me turn on the Family Search option. And after I restart Ancestral Quest, note that I now have a Family Search menu and family tree icons that let me interface directly with the Family Search. To learn more about how to use this feature, go to the Family Search menu and come down to View Tutorial, where you can learn more about use of this feature. Now that I've shown you some of the possibilities of what Ancestral Quest can do for you after you've entered a fair amount of data, let me show you very quickly how you would get started if you're a brand new user. So let me go ahead and close this file, and let's create a brand new file. We'll give it a name. Typically, you might use your surname for the name of your file. We'll create the database, and we're ready to get started. We'll go ahead and add our first person. With the information entered, I'll click the Save button. We are now in the Family view, ready to add spouses, children, fathers, and mothers. Let me add President Eisenhower's father by clicking the Add Father button, and we'll type in his information. And we'll save that. Whenever a relationship is created, as you add people, you'll be presented with this screen that lets you enter in the relationship or marriage information. And we'll save this. Let me add the mother. And we'll save that. Notice how quickly we're building this family. Let's move this generation over into the primary position. And go ahead and add some of the siblings. So I can click on Add Child. And save that record. As you can see, that's all there is to it. If you've got a family, continue to add children as necessary. Add parents, move them into position, or move a child into position. Whoever gets put into the primary position, from there you add their spouses, their children, their father, and their mother, and then you shift the next person into the primary position and continue to add your records. You can later add notes and sources, you can add scrapbook items, you can add to-do items and create research logs, and you can search the internet as you continue to build your family. If you already have a database that you started in another genealogy program, or you inherited some data from someone else who entered their data in another program, you can import that data into Ancestral Quest rather than having to type it from scratch. In order to do that, they would have to have done an export. Typically, genealogy programs have an export capability that creates a GEDCOM file. Let's go ahead and show you how to do that. I'm going to close this database, and then we'll open a GEDCOM file. Once you locate the folder that has the file, select the GEDCOM file, open it, import to a new file, select the folder into which you want to put your new database, and give it a new name, whatever you want to call it. Then go ahead and import. And you now have the data imported from the other source. It's that easy. One other thing, for those of you that are using Personal Ancestral File, one of the other family tree programs that was derived from a licensed version of Ancestral Quest, there is a very quick and easy way to work with your current path data with Ancestral Quest. Let me show you how to do that. We'll close Ancestral Quest. Simply open up Path from your desktop. This will bring up the database you have been using in Path. Go to the Tools menu. When you installed Ancestral Quest or Ancestral Quest Basics, Path added Ancestral Quest as a tool within Path. Select Ancestral Quest from this Tools menu. Path will close the file and instruct Ancestral Quest to open the same file. At this point, your data can be viewed and edited with Ancestral Quest. You do not need to use Path anymore if you don't want to, but you could continue to use both Ancestral Quest and Path if you so desire. That's how easy it is to upgrade from Path to Ancestral Quest. Thank you for your time in watching this video. As you can see, Ancestral Quest is a wonderful tool which will help you record your family tree, organize your genealogical information, research additional family tree details, and share your results. We wish you the best of success in your genealogical efforts.